Keep going, Helix. You're almost to 100 jumps. 91, 92, 93. Oh, man. I almost made a new record. That thunder messed me up. That's okay, Helix. We'll just start again.
Oh, no. My hat is getting wet.
Yeah. Guess we'll have to take a rain check. Ha. Get it?
I can't believe you guys wanted to come inside. I absolutely love playing in the rain. Splashing around in puddles is so fun. Plus, rain isn't just for playing. It is a very important part of something called the water cycle. The water cycle is really quite simple. It's only made up of four parts. Let's start with collection, shall we? See how the water is being collected into that marshy pool? When the rain comes down, it is collected in different water sources, like oceans, rivers, lakes, and marshes. And that's how we get water. Us and every other living thing on the planet. Every living thing on planet Earth needs water to survive, including plants and animals? Yes, we need water, animals need water, and plants need water. That's why it's so important that we get regular rainstorms. When we don't get enough rain, the living creatures of Earth don't get enough water. Without enough water, plants and animals cannot live. The second part of the water cycle is called evaporation. Evaporation is when the sun's rays shine down onto our water sources, and some of it turns into tiny water droplets. So small, we can't even see them. Those droplets then go back up into the sky to be collected in clouds.
So the water goes back up in the sky, but where does it end up?
That brings us to the third step in the water cycle. It is called condensation. You see those clouds up there?
Of course we see them. They're huge.
And so dark. Well, the reason they are so dark and big is because they are full of all the tiny water droplets that were evaporated.
That's what condensation is. Oh, I get it. The clouds catch all the water that is evaporated by the sun's rays.
That brings us to the final step of the water cycle. Precipitation.
Do you mean rain?
Yes, that's exactly what I mean. After the clouds collect enough evaporated water, they get full and have to release it again. That's what happens when it rains. See? Rain is important. Without it, we wouldn't have a water cycle. And without a water cycle, nothing could live on the Earth. Do you now know the four parts of the water cycle? Let's review the water cycle, shall we? The first step is called collection. When it rains, water collects in puddles, ponds, marshes, or even oceans. Then, when the sun comes up, the water goes into the air in tiny little droplets we cannot see. That is called evaporation. Once in the air, the water droplets gather in the clouds, causing them to turn dark. This step of the water cycle is called condensation. When the clouds become full of condensed water, the droplets get so big and heavy that they fall to the ground in the form of rain. This is the final step and is called precipitation, which we know as rain. When the water reaches the ground, it begins to collect in puddles, ponds, marshes, or oceans, and the water cycle begins again.